everyone, welcome back to another Undead World Hero Survival episode. Today, another discussion on a tier list, but this one is an updated version of what I put out before. We've had a lot of data already in determining the performance more or less of most or some of these heroes, and we have two new heroes to add to this list. By the way, guys, please be gentle with your comments. These are just my opinions, and I am actually all ears if you have a valid point in terms of some of the heroes going up, some of the heroes going down. And without further ado, let's start this video. Okay, starting with Niles. So again, all of you know Niles, nothing special, squishy, low damage, needs a rework. So that is it. Not a long story for Niles. So we're going to go to our tier B. First on tier B is actually going to be, we're going to start from the right to the left. So Jones, a very squishy tank. That's it. I've used him for quite a while and I believe it's so. Abigail performs better than him because I have two of them on my team. He dies quickly, I tell you. So that is why for a tank, he doesn't really fulfill his duties. That is why he's in B. Next is going to be Sam. So Sam's kit leans towards PvP, kinda in the bottom part of PvP, but not really enough to push him up. And for PvE, there are better AoE damage dealers, so that is why he is in B. Next is going to be Bella. So kit is specialized for PvP. Again, her kit is mostly debuffs, not a lot of damage output, and also she's very squishy. You need Astra for her to survive. So again, that is why she is in B. Next is going to be Henry. So kit for PvE. So mostly for PvE. Specialized in zombies. Not really for PvP. So again, his kit is very one-dimensional and very specialized. That is why he's at B. And the last for B is going to be Caddy. So skill mechanics needs improvement. What I'm talking about is actually the leveling up of her. Her kit is centered around leveling up to the next weapon. So again, I think it just needs a tweak to a bit more usable. But again, she really needs that, you know, that improvement in terms of how to, you know, how to make her mechanics shine more, not only just leveling up to a next weapon, as you can see in her kit. So again, this is my tier B. So most of them are very one-sided or either have a very, you know, glaring impact on their kit or their playstyle. So next is going to be tier A. So we're going to be starting with Lee. So good one-on-one buffer and healer. What can I say? I'm actually a fan of her in terms of healing big with one hero and also buffing one hero. I'm actually good for that, especially for PvP. But again, based on her kit, it's actually just average. So next is going to be Nadim. Nadim, healer, poison. But I'm afraid his heals are not quite significant. That is why I'm putting him in A. He's very limited right now in PvE. Not so much usage in PvP. Okay, next is going to be Cookie, right beside Nadim. So this is going to be Cookie. Good all around AoE damage and buffs, but the damage is, I don't know if I'm wrong, but it's not significant at this point. But again, the buffs that she gives to her team is actually very good. Next is going to be Tanya. Tanya, superb melee. The problem with her is her survivability, and she needs, you know, Astra again for you to maximize her. So she's actually good for both PvE and PvP. Again, she just has a handicap. And the last for A is going to be Kieran. So multiple hits, multiple targets, but average damage output. So sad to say, even if how good you hit zombies or enemies, but if you don't deal that much damage, I'm afraid you'll be just be average. So again, these are your tier A for this tier list. Next is going to be tier S. So these are nearing the top or the creme de la creme already. They are very good in their own right. They could be in SS, but again, with the role that they have, they are actually just a notch lower than SS category. So we start with Webster. So Webster, great buffer, crit damage and accuracy, good damage and range. So again, I like the sniper, positions himself well, and he has his weaknesses, especially for a sniper. Very squishy, especially if you reach him, but again, he's in tier S. Next is going to be Rock. So Rock, very, very good in clearing stages, multiple waves, one of the best AoE damage dealers that we have, but there's one better than her, which is in tier SS. So we'll talk about that later. Next is going to be Lita. So good overall support, attack, stun, taunt, and block. So again, there are a lot of buffs that you get from her, but I'm afraid support doesn't really have a place in SS. She can support a lot of heroes, but not really dish out punishment that much. So again, that is why she's in S. Next is going to be Gabriel. So he is a formation disruptor. Absorbs attack while backline does damage. I've seen his play. He is usually the decoy that charges in while your enemies, you know, punch at him, while you also shoot at your enemies. And he is actually terrific in PvP. One of the top heroes in PvP that I've seen and more or less I've gone up against. So again, Gabriel is at tier S. Next is going to be Tyler, one of the top melee heroes that we have. So Tyler, good off tank and HP regeneration. He is solid, but not enough to take him to SS. He doesn't have that oomph factor in terms of his kit. That is why he's in S. I'm not saying he's bad, but again, he's not the best either. But he is, you know, he is right there already. Right there. Nearly at SS. Last for S is going to be Connor. So ally, defense buff, stuns enemy. Very, very tough tank. So that is what I like about Connor. So again, I think one of the top tanks that we have together with Gabriel. So, but they are at SS. For Connor, what he's missing is more on the offensive side of him. That is why he is in tier S. So let's move to tier SS. So as you can see here, Murray is now in SS. Proven to be good, very, very good in your PvE and PvP. For me, really a god in terms of both content. You can put him in any team, any scenario, and he will perform for you. Single damage. He also has crowd control with the spikes that he throws. So again, very, very good. Never thought that this guy would be this good. Okay, next is going to be Brittany. So Brittany, what you like about Brittany is you can bring her in PvP and PvE. Especially, what I like with her especially is her ultimate, which really, you know, has very big sustained damage. That is the key. So SP boot as well, big sustained damage for the ultimate, which really you need in PvE, but also very crucial in PvP. So let's go back to Murray first. So Murray, very good CC and single target damage. Again, I mentioned it. I'm sorry, I forgot. But both of them are fantastic. If you have them on your team, and if you're Blue Banshee, then it's really a must that you level up both of them. Next is going to be Astra. So, of course, for Astra, Revive and Crowd Control, especially for zombies. So that is why he is still very relevant in PvP and also in PvE. Next is going to be Helen. So Helen is the zombie, Resurrect, Disruptor, Lifesteal, heals as well, defense, debuff, and absorbs damage. So you name it, she has it. She has a lot of utility as well as toughness as well as damage. So what can you ask for Helen? It's just that it's really hard for her to level up because of her rarity and also with Astra. But again, she's at SS. Next is going to be Meredith. Meredith is going to be shield, defensive buff, silence, CC, and resistance. So all of the protection you're gonna need is in Meredith. So her shield is actually terrific. Defense buff. And I just learned, I think yesterday, that she has silence as well. So again, this solidifies her place in SS tier. Last for the SS tier is going to be Abigail. So Abigail is really a melee disguised as a tank. Dishes out a lot of punishment, a lot of damage, and is also tough. So that is what I like about Abigail. I've been using Abigail from the start. And again, I can depend upon her clearing zombies, clearing enemies in PvP. And what can I say? Probably the best tank right now in the game. That is it, guys. So I hope that I did this tier list justice. So anyway, for comments, suggestions, I hope there aren't any violent reactions to this tier list, but again, I'm open to what you guys are gonna say. I'm open to the opinions of everybody. Just put it in the comment section and we will discuss. Okay, guys, so that is it for me. For those who have stuck this far, please consider subscribing. Again, your help is very welcome, and it really helps my channel a lot. And if you don't want to miss any Undead World videos, please click that bell icon and put a like to this video. Thank you, guys. Stay safe. Take care. This is the Warden, and I'm out of here.